I think the first thing to be aware of is some of the fraud statistics that are out there that are really kind of frightening. On average, businesses lose 7% of their annual revenue to fraud. And for small businesses, that's an average of $200,000 a year. So it's huge. And in a veterinary hospital, the primary ways that employees might steal from a practice, that's what fraud really is stealing, is through misappropriation of assets, primarily cash and inventory. So I think the first step is that awareness piece. And it's called a fraud triangle, and the legs of those triangles are the incentive or the pressure to commit fraud, usually because of financial problems. There's the perceived opportunity. There's not enough internal controls in place, so the person who's committing the fraud feels like there's no risk to doing it. And then the third leg of that triangle is rationalization. It's okay that I do this. I deserve a raise, or I've been doing more than my fair share of the work around here, so I'm entitled to do this. So I think the first thing an owner, a business owner, or a practice manager needs to be aware of or look for are warning signs that fraud might be happening. Warning signs would be things like hearing lots of complaints about compensation or being undercompensated, or changes in lifestyle where suddenly they're driving new cars or wearing lots of new clothes or new jewelry and they're just living beyond their means. Other things to look for would be, certainly unexplained adjustments in the books or unexplained credits or excessive credits in your computer software. So those are some of the warning signs. And then I think really the preventions are to be sure that you've got strong internal controls in place. First and foremost, the owners have to lead by example, walk the talk. If you're communicating to your staff members that fraud is not acceptable and not appropriate, and it's not, but yet you're coming in and taking home a bag of dog food without paying for it, or taking inventory off the shelf without paying for it, you're sending a conflicting message to your staff members. On the one hand, you're telling them they can't do that, but on the other hand, you're doing it. So be sure that you are leading by example. Have a segregation of duties so that you don't have the same person doing responsible for every step in the process. For example, inventory. You've got one person perhaps that does the ordering, a second person who stocks the shelf and checks the order to make sure that everything came in correctly as it was ordered, and then a third person who's actually paying the bill. So be sure you've got that segregation of duties.